的老祖宗开发了整个南海了。
从明代整个西洋之前，我们就已经开发南海。
通过南海与世界的连通，一直绵延不断。
没有断续线，南海的秩序可能会更乱。
可以排除不适用第三方强制仲裁。
The legality of China's claims, is not weak.
事实上，中国不是改变现状。
We hope that the Philippine government does not push it too far.
Early in the morning, the monsoon rolls in, and the scent of the sea fills the air. Tanmen's fishermen have breathed it for centuries. Captain Lu Jiabing heads to the tea house to meet his old friends. The veteran captains all once navigated the South China Sea. Their time in the tides and winds lives on as cherished memories, a lifetime commitment to peace in the waters. Tanmen Port is known as the gateway to the South China Sea. Its over 30,000 residents work on China's maritime frontier. Today's fishermen not only face the perils of the open ocean, but the uncertain situation in the region as well. Looking south, the vast expanse of the sea stretches out. Its abundance and vitality sustain Tanmen's people, who have called it home for thousands of years. Like many here, Lu Jiabing's ancestors were all fishermen. What distinguishes Lu's family is a treasured family heirloom. It's an ancient navigation book of the South China Sea. Tanmen people called it Geng Lu Bu, which means road map. Geng Lu Bu is one key to the identity of the Tanmen people and to China's territorial claims in the South China Sea.
This book Geng Lu Bu has how many years? I don't know what year it is.
罗环上这个指尖呢，这个尖呢就对准南北，指就是在指北的方向，五是南的方向，一个国一个字，总共是24个国在里面，一个国是15度，整个来说是等于现在的360度。在茫茫大海面之后，罗环和根六部爽释了一片海。
This line says, from the Xisha Islands, 潘石屿。To the Nansha Islands, Shuangzi, following the direction of the central line between the Qian, Xun, Si, and Hai directional markers, which is southeastward. It covers a distance of some 28 gong.
28 gong.
Among Tanmen's ancient fishermen, there were several hundred Geng Lu Bu in circulation. Lu Jiabing's manuscript is one of the most detailed. It records 135 routes, 84 are in the Nansha Islands and 38 are in the Xisha Islands.
I was able to get my father's 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 father 对，美济岛是我们叫做双门，还有这个是
一段这样连起来的，
所以我们就为了方便的记忆叫做断节，那官方的名字叫做仁爱礁。
仁爱 reef is known in the west as the second Thomas Shoal. The Philippines call it Ayuning Shoal. There have been increasing tensions off Renai Reef. In 1999, a Philippine Navy vessel was intentionally grounded there. China says the Philippines repeatedly promised to tow it away, but 25 years on, the Sierra Madre is still there. Some of China's neighbors say many islands and reefs claimed by China belong to them. China stresses that its fishermen were the first explorers in the South China Sea, and Genglubu is ironclad proof of China's sovereignty over the disputed islands and reefs since ancient times. Professor Zhou Weimin has been researching Genglubu since 1989 at Hainan University. His book on Genglubu was published in 2015, 2 years after the Philippines initiated its arbitration against China.
把它叫做南海天书，就是到南海去的人们用的一种天书，就是一般人看不懂，就只有船长看懂的。我们在书里面那个明确的说明，我们渔民们呢，就是从明代建国西洋之前，我们就已经开放南海。
Zhou says Genglubu dates back over 600 years ago, but only a few remain.
这些老船长啊，一般Genglubu啊，伴他一生。就让他一生发大财，所以他们这个对南海啊有很深厚的感情。所以这个老船长啊，都老的时候，都是把根部啊这个拿来那个慢慢的看一看。都死的时候呢，他的家人就把这个根部连同这个老人的衣服啊一起烧掉了。
Zhou Weimin's book contains 24 versions, centuries of hard-won experience.Every island, its features and surrounding waters are clearly described. Zhou says the maps are much more than just guidebooks.
我们做大量的田野调查，来征集大量的那个根部，把它编成书，那么人们就可以继续研究它。除了那个历史证明、考古证据以外的一个最重要的一个民间的文书。
This model boat was a gift from a Tanmen fishing boat captain.
这个船呢，是老船长苏成芬。他在老的时候，他说我可能快要死了，就用这个海里面沉船那个不腐朽的木头，他给我做一个这个，做一个这个船模。人们再一看这个船模呢，就知道当年风帆时代没有机动船的时候，我们是怎么劳作的。你比如说他这个竹筒啊，他其实是很简单，但是呢他说船呢、啊、在海上的航行呢、啊、如果那个火柴这个打湿了，所以有时候就一天两天开不了火。苏成芬他们把这个火柴放在这个竹筒里面，这个就是把它盖上，多大的海浪这个水就进不去。这些渔民呢、啊，他都是有很多智慧。
We met Su Chengfen in 2015. He was 80 years old when he was building this model.
这个的形状，大风个条那个船啊，过那个大浪啊，它那砸落去水桶到这里，大一下的那露起来啊，没有方向就看见干嘛搞事情嘛。
Su Chengfen's family has 3 Genglubu.Their maps cover most of the disputed islands, including Huangyan Island, also known as the Scarborough Shoal. Su Chengfen died in 2021. He wanted students at Zhou's University to know how his ancestors sailed the South China Sea. Zhou Weimin says the outside world needs to know the full extent of China's historical claims.The historical documents provide the context in which the current tensions are unfolding. That's next on the program. Professor Wu Shicun has been tirelessly advocating China's sovereignty in the South China Sea for decades. He's the founder of the National Institute for South China Sea Studies. The more he studies, the more he believes that China has the best basis of territorial claims.
南海问题它本质上是一个南沙争端，它也是中国和部分南海沿岸国围绕南沙群岛的部分岛礁的领土争议，这是它的实质，以及由岛礁争议引发的海洋管辖主张争议。
Without permission, you are not allowed to enter the sea area.
The current tensions over Renai Reef and Huangyan Island touch upon the core issue of ownership.George Yao is an academic as well as a former Singaporean foreign minister.
During the period of colonialism, countries were not yet born. So when they were born, they thought it very unfair that almost all the South China Sea should have been claimed by China. So I think this is at the heart of it.
Wu Shicun says neighboring countries began illegal occupation of the Nansha Islands in the 1970s, drawn by resources and strategic advantages.That's when the Philippines began its claims. But it wasn't until 2011 that Manila redrew its map to include Huangyan Island and Renai Reef. These islands lie west of the 118-degree line, a boundary established by a series of international treaties.
事实上，是这些国家非法侵占的这些岛礁，他要试图把它合理化。要让国际社会认可，所以这就是他们推动南海问题的国际化和南海问题扩大化的真正的目的所在。1999年5月8号，中国驻南联盟的使馆被炸。那么菲律宾，你看你顾不上南海的事了，所以紧接着就5月9号，用一艘二战时候的坦克登陆舰拉到那去。等我们发现的时候，通过外交交涉要菲律宾拖走的时候，他承诺修好了以后，我一定会拖走。
Citing humanitarian concerns, China allowed the Philippines to use civilian vessels for resupplying. However, they required inspection and prior notification. Then in February 2023, the Marcos government chose to end the gentleman's agreement.
所以仁爱礁的实质是菲律宾以废弃的军舰来戳滩，试图永久控制仁爱礁，那么中国肯定是要制止的。
Much of what the Philippines is now doing is the result of domestic politics. President Duterte reached some kind of an understanding with China, including the beach LSD on Renai Jiao, but under President Marcos, they felt that that was unfair, and they want to repair that ship which is breaking down.And that's the proximate cause of the current tension.
我带你看看
这个。Wu Shicun explains China's historical rights of the Nine Dash Line, or the Dotted Line, the cornerstone of China's claims. This map was drawn by authorities of the Republic of China in 1946. And in 1948, China released the official administration map of the Republic of China and the South Sea Islands location map.11 dashes mark is territorial sovereignty and maritime jurisdiction. At that time, there were no objections from the international community.
它这是1992年美国一家这个私营出版公司出版的。很有意思的是，它把西沙群岛和南沙群岛分别用汉语拼音。你看，西沙群岛下面一个括号 China， 这是西沙群岛，这里也是南沙群岛括号 China。在90年代，美国出版的地图，它是明确这个南沙群岛和西沙群岛的主人是中国，所以它的历史是这样的，就是二战结束之后，原先由日本人非法侵占的南海诸岛回到中国人手里，中国人随后公布一张地图，啊，告诉你这个南海诸岛回到中国人手里，它的地理位置在哪，这条线奠定了或者说规范了。重申了中国对南海诸岛的主权。
有人说，如果中国没有设立九段线，南海就可以太平无争了。
没有断续线，南海的秩序可能会更乱。断续线它实际上它代表它不只是中国对南海诸岛的主张。我认为，断续线 它是对二战之后南海秩序的一种确立。然后我在很多国际场合我质问这些西方学者，中国的南海权利和主张，这是二战后的国际秩序订定下来的，中国收复了二战期间被日本人侵占的南沙群岛，就南海诸岛。
不是中国在改变现状，相关的有些国家在改变现状吗？
那什么叫现状？我认为要谈现状，那就是二战后南海回到中国人手里。谁打破的现状？首先这些国家，南海周边国家非法侵占已经属于中国的南海诸岛。事实上中国不是改变现状，中国是要把南海的现状，就是已经被这些国家改变的现状，要把它再改变过来。
Many experts have criticized the Philippines for distorting historical facts.
There's an entire file of the French Ministry of Foreign Affairs, a legal file from 1974 to 79, denouncing the Filipino claims. With the United States, there are certain comical records of an Assistant Secretary Murphy in the 1950s saying that it is quite obvious that the Filipinos have absolutely no legal claim to any of these islands, but it is in our interest, in any event, to encourage them to make claims in order to keep the commies, the Chinese communists at bay.
西方国家质疑中国，古代渔民曾经到过这里，不能够说那里就属于你的领土。
中国也从来没说渔民到哪里领土主张就到哪里。当时在南海活动的渔民，应该说是中国是唯一的。那时候南海周边国家，那都是中国的一些附属国。
Evidence of a tangible nature dating back 8 centuries can be found at the China Museum of the South China Sea.
南海每年从11月份开始的东北季风，在没有马达的风帆时代，能够把我们的大船吹向远方。来年的5、6月份，西南季风起来还能回来。天时地利人和方面的这个优势，让我们有可能开启这个辉煌的海上丝绸之路。中国是一个大国，有对外交往的需求，有高超的造船能力。
这是当时世界上最先进的海船，我们在唐宋时期就掌握了水密隔舱技术，这个是西方大航海时代才开始使用，应该找了至少是700多年的历史。
通过对这些文物和船体的研究呢，我们知道至少在800年前的南宋时期，中国跟海上丝绸之路的沿线国家和地区的交流是非常繁密的，通过南海与世界的连通一直绵延不断。
华光家一号呢，总共出了10000多件文物，有3000多件的粉盒。我经常形容它，这是800年前的爆款。
比如说这个是折枝牡丹，这上面有团菊纹，7星花卉，颜色不一，湖岸都有区别。
我们在南海发现了138处文物点，那么这138处文物点，实际上经过我们这么多年来的这个调查，考古发掘和研究，全部都是中国人留下的，就是在南海的广袤的这片岛礁和相关海域能够看得出来，长期以来主要是中国人在这里，这个作业、通过和使用。从目前我们的这个文物的调查和考古发掘和对文物的研究来看呢，确实这个地方，是中国人最早发现、最早命名、最早使用和管辖的一个区域。
现在我们来到这个图呢，我们看是叫郑和航海图，是郑和第6次下西洋回来以后，组织人画的，指导后边航海的，涉及30多个国家，40-50条航线，反映了这个郑和下西洋沿途所经历的很多的地方。像这个区域就是经过了海南，经过了南海，这万里石塘就是南沙。
Many ancient Chinese maps identify the Nansha Islands as Wanli Shitang. They are marked as the territory of the Ming Dynasty going back to the 17th century. All these Chinese experts say China's history of continuous use and exercise of authority spans over 2,000 years. No other country can provide more definitive evidence to support a claim. But today, with so much more at stake,Other countries are attempting to rewrite history, change the post-World War II status quo, and interpret international laws in their own interest.
考古呢，能够让我们还原历史，能够补史正史，知其所来，失其所在，明其将往。
In 2013, the Philippines unilaterally initiated arbitration, setting the scene for a legal showdown. Next on the program. The Philippines was the first to challenge China through international dispute settlement procedures. China says the Philippines' case is inherently flawed. It sought compulsory arbitration and misrepresented the real nature of the disputes. China points out that this arbitration case directly relates to territorial sovereignty and maritime delimitation. But territorial issues are not regulated by and therefore are beyond the scope of the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, known as UNCLOS. And in 2006, China declared it would exclude disputes concerning maritime delimitation from compulsory arbitration. Retired Philippine Justice Antonio Carpio was one of the consultants for the Philippine government in the arbitration. It's no surprise that he has an entirely different view.
Because when China ratified UNCLOS, China agreed that all disputes, all claims rather, all historical claims will be extinguished. That's the key.
China sees his claims as deliberate distortions. China never agreed that ratification would supersede all historical claims.
遵守联合国海洋法公约的有关条款和我们坚持历史性权利是不矛盾的，因为历史性权利超出了公约条件的范畴。
王翰林 is an expert on the law of the sea at the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences. He's also a former consultant to the Division for Ocean Affairs and the Law of the Sea of the UN Office of Legal Affairs. He says there is solid international legal basis for China to oppose this case, and the Philippines' unilateral initiation of arbitration falls short of meeting the UNCLOS conditions. Wang says the crux of the China-Philippines disputes is exactly territorial sovereignty and maritime boundary delimitation. He cites Article 298 of UNCLOS to explain why the third-party compulsory procedures should not have been applied.
里边就规定了这个，缔约国在批准加入这个公约的时候，可以排除不接受。第三方的强制程序，包括海洋划界、军事活动、历史性所有权和相关的权益。
王翰林 says the Philippines claims the Rinnai Reef, because it's within its exclusive economic zone and continental shelf, lack legal footing.
专注经济区和大陆架的划界，应该在国际法的基础上，通过谈判协商。达成协议来解决。显然，菲律宾没有诚意跟我国进行海洋划界的这个谈判。
China says it's impossible to discuss most of the claims without first clarifying Chinese sovereignty. And the land dominates the sea principle means that all of the Philippine claims are essentially maritime delimitation claims that involve questions of sovereignty.
不是因为他们有这个海岸。有领土，然后呢，就可以随意的往南海方向主张相关的海域，以中国在南海有领土主权和海洋划界争端的这些国家，他们都只提到联合国海洋法公约，这个是不对的。
Wang stressed that territorial disputes are governed by the UN Charter and general international laws, not UNCLOS.The Philippines is also claiming many disputed islands and reefs which are closer to its territory in the South China Sea.
地理邻近的这个主张啊，从来就不是国际法上取得领土主权的一个依据。比如说，在英吉利海峡的海峡群岛，它距离法国北部的诺曼底海岸只有20公里左右，但是它属于英国，而不属于。
In 1925, the U.S. asserted the island of Palmas belonged to the Philippines, which was under U.S. colonial rule. But the Permanent Court of Arbitration awarded sovereignty to the Netherlands, disregarding the principle of geographical proximity. Manila's key historical evidence in its case against Beijing is this colonial map, dating back over 200 years ago.
We presented the 1734 Murillo Velarde map, the first official map of Philippine territory during the Spanish regime. It shows Panakot, which is Scarborough Shoal, as part of Philippine territory.
Chinese experts say one 18th century map cannot stand up against hundreds of Genglubu, which predated by 300 years, and territory can't be decided by one map alone.
Because it itself is a sea map, and it's a traditional map, made by itself. It's not a Philippine official map, so it's not legal.
The tribunal ruled in favor of the Philippines. Beijing's position is clear. The ruling is illegal and invalid. No acceptance, no participation, no recognition, and no implementation.
I remember reading through the UNCLOS tribunal report. It was about 400 pages. And I thought it was kind of strange because China wasn't there and it adjudged to be a weak case. I think the legality of China's claims is not weak at all, but it's not well presented in non-Chinese languages.
Herman Tulorel is president of the Asian Century Philippine Strategic Studies Institute. He says the Philippines' changing attitude toward China reflects U.S. influence.
So why this change is, the real factor is the Americans behind the scene. They have this project called Nyushu Project, which in Japanese means brilliant move. The goals were to exact a reputational cost on China, which is to damage its reputation internationally. And the United States is trying to come back with its hegemony in Asia. The Americans have the plan to station a combined forward operating base of the American military at Ayung Inchol, at the BRP Sierra Madre. Because the Ayung Inchol is in a strategic area of the South China Sea, they are trying also to establish as many bases spread all over the first island chain.
Herman Tulorel believes that President Marcos will further entrench the Philippines under U.S. control.
Well, most people will believe that he has compliance now. He has expressed compliance with the American desire in exchange for the return of the Marcos wealth. The other is that he has been threatened by the U.S. proxies in the country to be deposed the way his father was deposed.
China seeks bilateral resolution for territorial disputes. With more non-claimant states involved, ASEAN's position becomes crucial.
When the Philippines took China to UNCLOS, it never consulted ASEAN. So ASEAN felt no obligation to support the Philippines. And over the second Thomas Shoal or Ren Ai Chiao, ASEAN shows great discomfort because they really don't want escalation and conflict in their own backyard.
Many observers argue that the arbitration only delayed resolving the disputes. Further tension is looming large.
So we hope that the Philippine government does not push it too far, because even the panda has its patience and its limits.